Pedro Gomes started at Arquivo.pt in 2019 and currently is a research development researcher. He obtained his master's degree in computer science in 2019. His thesis focused on detecting user sessions and inferring user satisfaction in the context of a search engine. So, Pedro, welcome. I'd like to invite you to open your microphone and to share your slides. Thank you, Pedro.
Thank you, Nicola. So, hello, my name is Pedro, and I am a researcher and developer at Arquivo.pt, and I'm here to presenting enhancing access to research the GeoCities historical collection. First of all, what is Arquivo.pt? The Arquivo.pt is a Portuguese web archive initiative which preserves historical web content. Arquivo.pt permanently selects, archives, and provides public access to its web collections. So in these two examples, you can see two web pages. On the left side, you can see the oldest Portuguese web pages from Minho University from 1996. And in the right side, you can see the page from CERN, which is the European Laboratory for Particle Physics, also from 1996. We are continuously indexing the preserved information in order to be free so anyone can search and view. At the same time, we are also increasing our collection and user community, and we crawl the PT domain 3 times per year, and we run a daily and monthly crawl of the Portuguese news website. So what was GeoCities? GeoCities was one of the first social networks created in 1994, and in 1999 GeoCities was acquired by Yahoo and it became the third most popular platform. In April 2009, Yahoo announced that we'll shut down GeoCities and deleting more than 38 million pages created by users all around the world. Then the archive team announced a project to archive GeoCities pages, resulting in a torrent file. Now I can show you some examples. Here you can see the first digital art exhibition, web pages with the Apple Macintosh technical specifications, and the web pages with the lyrics from Kiss's album. In addition to the web pages preserved by Internet Archive and Arquivo.pt, there are two specialized initiatives related with this torrent file. The first is oocities.com, which has some limitations. For instance, don't have the correct URL beginning with geocities.com, and it uses the Google custom search engine as a full text search. The second initiative is geocities.ws, which has the same, more or less the same limitations. Why do you integrate geocities in Arquivo.pt? GeoCities reflects societies during a disruptive period of mankind, the beginning of the internet. For instance, I'm 25 years old and I was born when this page was preserved, which is quite interesting to analyze. Also, GeoCities has an international relevance since it has websites of all nationalities and countries. Although there is some limitations to research GeoCities, first, no original URLs, limited full text search, no image search, no APIs, and limited technical options. So what are the challenges to integrate GeoCities in Arquivo.pt? First, how to convert HTML files to WARC format. The information was not in ISO standard web archive, which is WARC, which is recognized by most national library systems as the standard to follow for web archiving. So use the open source project called WARC-IT from Web Record Institution, which is a command line tool to convert directives of the web documents like HTML into WARC files. The second challenge is to choose the URL default for each folder. In the example, you can see the difference between choose uk.geocities.com or just geocities.com. Finally, the last challenge is to identify the correct timestamp for each web page. So, in order to find the optimal timestamp that defines the collected files, we decided that for each folder, we'll set the timestamp with the last update from each folder. I will explain in more detail in the next slide. So, how did we integrate GeoCities in archive.pt? First, we need to unzip all the files, resulting in the following structure. First, we have a folder called lowercase, and then we have subfolders until we reach the folder of the page. In this case, is JSON the stamps. Then we have other folders, like uppercase, numbers, and so on. And then we have a folder called subsites, which has identification of the subsite. In this case, is uk.geocities.com. In the second step, for each folder, we'll get the timestamp from the last update of the files inside each folder. For instance, this folder was last updated in 2009. And then we will use the ARKit comment tool with some parameters. We can see an example on the bottom. So we need to call ARKit, and then we'll set the timestamp with 2009. Then we'll put the domain. In this case, will be geocities.com, and then we need to put the path to the folder, this path. Then this comment line tool will result in a WARC file. Finally, in the last step, we'll merge each individual WARC file and removing the revisit records, since these records will have the current timestamp. In the example, we can see the file index.html, as you can see here. And also ARKit find other HTML files. In this case, we found kenya.html. Some information about the collection. This collection is from 24th April 2009 until 13th November of 2010. And we have stored 280 gigabytes of information that corresponds to 35 million of collected files. And in the right side, you can see some examples. So, methods to research GeoCities. The GeoCities archive.pt collection has a special search link. In this case, it will be archive.pt/search-geocities, where you can easily search and replay the preserved pages. We have the functionalities like full-text search, image search, and page replay. The access to this information is free, and collaborations with researchers are welcome. Now, I will show some examples. In here, you can see an example of the full-text search, and you need to put the query, like virus, and then you need to put the name of the collection. In this case, GeoCities. Then we have the image search, and then we have the replay options. So if you click on options, will appear this bar. In this bar, there is some technical options. If you click, for example, in technical details, you can see some details from the web page. For instance, the title, the original URL, the timestamp, the diagnosis from the WARC file, the link to the screenshot, the link to the structured text, and the spinet of the page. We also have an integration with Allbed today. We just need to click on replay with other browser, and you can see GeoCities with the old browser. Then we have a component called complete page. So if you see a page with missing resources, we can just click on complete page, and we will try to recover the resources missing with other web archive initiatives or with the live web. On archive.pt/API, you can find more information about the APIs that we make available to the community, like CDC Server API, Momentum API, Page Search API, and Image Search API. The API will return a JSON file. There is an example. We can use those APIs to automatically process the piece of information, and we can use in different objects. Now, some conclusions. Due to this historical relevance, the GeoCities collection has been used to conduct research studies in several areas, such as arts, humanity, or sociology. And we believe that by improving access to the GeoCities historical collection, it has a potential to originate innovative scientific collaborations and maintaining the scientific value of the previous studies. Thus, we decided to integrate the GeoCities collection in the Qubes.pt so that national and international researchers could benefit from our assessment tools. Finally, if you do a research based on this collection or other collection from Qubes.pt, you can apply to Qubes.pt annual award and you can win 10,000 US. If you want to see how to win this award, you can go to Qubes.pt/awards. And that is it. We are not researchers. We just build the collection for you, you know. So, but our process to index all the pages have all the language and is not specific to Portugal or English, for instance. It's for all language. It's all included, but we did not do a research of how many linguals that you have. It's the same thing to index Portuguese or English. We don't have a special ranking, for instance, for Portuguese or for Spanish. We expose everything that you can expose. So most everything we expose, if has relevance to the resources. So everything is exposed, the link to the extract test, the spinet, the page, the name of the WR, for instance, everything is exposed. And if you want more parameters, more features, you can send an email and we can see if you can do it or not.